Let's see how to create an avatar and use it in a Teams meeting. But before we go ahead, let's understand why would you like to use avatars in the first place? One is you have had some kind of video fatigue because you are doing too many video calls and you want to use your avatar instead of your video so that people still know there is some dynamism there, but your video is off. And the second reason is for whatever reasons, you are not comfortable switching on video, but you still want to have a higher level of participation in the meetings which go on. Now, generally, avatars will be used when you are attending, but I've also seen many presenters use avatar, and the reason is there are a lot of reactions which avatar can do. We will see those as we go along. In order to use this, we need the public preview version of Teams as of today. That's April 2023. So you go to the three dots in Teams, About, and Enable Public Preview. As soon as you do that, it'll ask you to restart. And now you will have public preview. To enable avatars in a Teams meeting, the first step is to create an avatar. How do you do that? Left side menu, three dots, search for an app called Avatars, add the app, and then you will be presented with the creation screen. The first step in creating an avatar is to choose one of the starting points. Choose the one which is closest to what you want to create. You start by customizing the body type and the skin color. When you come to face, there are lots and lots of options available. Choose reasonable defaults and then we'll refine it in the second step. Now, one thing to remember while creating the avatar is that you can zoom in and zoom out with mouse wheel and drag to rotate at any point of time. Zoom and rotation helps us in refining features more accurately. For hair, we have hairstyle, facial hair, and eyebrows. Under appearance, we have many options related to makeup. And finally, we have wardrobe option where underwear, overwear, headgear, and eyewear or specs. Remember, it only shows up to the waist. It does not talk about your legs portion at all. So customize these as you need. And finally, your avatar will be ready. You can create three avatars. We have already created one. The other two, I can create from scratch or make a copy of the first one and then customize it. Now our avatar is ready. Let's see how to use it during Teams meetings. In fact, when you join the meeting, earlier we used to see a video preview. Along with that, you can also see avatar. Now remember, avatar does not use video camera input at all. It's a substitute to video. So you either use avatar or use video. Now, in case you already joined the meeting, and now you want to use an avatar, click on the three dots or more button and you will see effects and avatars, and then you choose the avatar from there. In addition to the avatar itself, you can change the mood of the avatar. It can be neutral or more happy. In addition, you can also change the cameras, can be slightly left facing, center or right facing. You also have a little bit of zoom in, zoom out capability depending on what you want to do. Once you choose the avatar, people can see it. Instead of your video, your avatar will be shown. Now remember, avatar does not take input from camera. So it's not going to look at what you are doing through the camera and try to emulate it in this 3D avatar. No, but it is looking or rather hearing you. So if you speak, then that avatar will speak. Now remember, we have some standard reactions during meetings. So those reactions are now integrated with avatar. So let's say I react as like, the avatar is actually going to show you that action. Heart or love, claps, laughter, and surprise. Avatars are capable of many more reactions. There are 44 reactions I've counted in this version. Emotions, greetings, celebrations, activities, ASL, which is American Sign Language, and miscellaneous. You can pin up to 5 of the most useful ones in your context. So I'm sure you found this useful. And before we go, I have a very popular video about Teams best practices. Have a look at that as well. So that is it for now. Thank you.